Good afternoon, everybody, or good morning, wherever you are. Good day, let's say that. This is, as Rachel said, a webinar about the relevance of Azure in combination with Dynamics 365 Business Central. Let's see if I can go to the next slide. Yeah, my name is Jan Veenendaal. I'm a technical guy at QBS, and I've been a long time NAV developer, Business Central developer. And one of the products that I've been working on for QBS is called Extension Agent. So maybe if you heard about that, that's me that you will be talking about if you're going to use that. Not only me, but also other people. Okay, Business Central and Azure. If we talk about Business Central in combination with Azure, maybe you think it is about Business Central in the cloud. Business Central cloud product, as Microsoft is doing that currently. But that's not what this is about. It's also what is it about, but not only that. Azure is relevant for any customer, for any partner, for all versions of Business Central, both on-premise and in the cloud. Doesn't matter. Whichever version of Business Central you're using, you can use Azure as a tool set to help you develop your product. So even from CSite, if you still are on CSite, have not converted anything to CAL, to AL yet, you can use Azure. And that's exactly what this webinar is about. Today, if we are talking about Business Central, we can't not talk about updates and upgrades. Because in the past, every few years, a new major version of NAV would come out years apart. And many customer solutions or many partner solutions would be developed on one version. And customers that were on that version would never upgrade until there was essentially a re-implementation going on a newer version. If you see this list from NAV 2009 to NAV 2018, is a period of 9 years. After that, Business Central came out, and we are currently on the fourth version of Business Central, and this fall there will be a next version, version 17 probably. And that's been 3 years. So you see that in 3 years we had as much upgrades or new versions as we had in the 9 years before. And I guess it will still speed up because nowadays new functionality is released even in the monthly updates. So every month you will get new functions in your Business Central environment. That means that upgrading is getting more and more difficult if you are not having that set up correctly. If you still have customers on NAV 2013 or 2015, and you want to go to Business Central version 16, which is the current version, actually, that's already a two-step process. And these two steps have many, many smaller steps in them, because you first have to go to Business Central version 14, and from 14 you have to go to 16. Of course, I know there's a lot of customers still on older versions, and the longer we wait, the harder it becomes to get them onto a recent version. If I go to Azure updates, they are even quicker, even more often. What you see here is a web page where you can see the features that have been released on Azure. This is from this morning. I'll click on it and see if I get to the latest version. It's still the same. But what you can see is that today something was released. Yesterday, 4 or 5 or 6 new features were released. Last week, almost every day, something new is available on Azure. It's all small things that are added, but it's expanding very rapidly. Now, if you want to go to Business Central 16, the current version from Business Central 14, and you go and watch the documentation available on the Microsoft website, then you find this picture. And this picture tells you if you have a code customized customer solution on Business Central 14, which is on the left bottom. Then to go to a full Business Central 16 update, you first have to convert your application to AL if you haven't done that. Then you have a customized base application, and from that you have to refactor. And that means that some things have to change because the base application of Microsoft has changed. And then you have to merge it to the current version, and then you have to maybe go to a SaaS version, a cloud version, or you still have to be, you can do that on-premise also. But it's a lot of steps and a lot of things that can go wrong or that need to be tested if you go, if you're going to update. That means it will take a lot of time for you and for your customers. But of course, if you go to, if you watch any solution that's available, then a typical installation is not only Business Central Standard, but there's an add-on probably involved, and probably more, 2 or 3 is quite usual. Then there's customization, and this is everything in the Business Central code. So this is CAL code or AL code, which modified the functioning of the software. But next to AL, we have a lot of other things around your solution. Probably you will be doing some storage of files, or you read files from a file system. Probably you'll have customized documents, new reports, external reports, maybe using Power BI or other tools. Maybe you import data from some external application, and probably not from 1, but 2 or 3. And also the other way around, if you have data in Business Central, you will maybe export that data to other applications. As I said, probably Power BI attached to Business Central or to NAV. Maybe you use .NET code. Maybe you use SQL scripts on your SQL server. So let's go to cloud, to Azure. That's what this session is about. And it may look like it's something like this. We have an on-premise solution and we move that one to cloud and we are ready. Well, that's not what we are talking about today. Because what you're essentially doing is moving your application from a server, a local server, an on-premise server, to probably virtual machines, virtual servers in the cloud, and make that accessible to your customers, users. But you're not really cloud enabling your solution in this way. You're just using the cloud to get it on there. But if I go and watch in my image of your application for things that Azure could do, let's start with the file storage that I mentioned. As long as you're on a on-premise server, or if you're on a virtual machine in the cloud, then you can access a file system on that server, and maybe even files on your client, your user computers. That becomes harder and harder, and in the cloud product of Business Central, it's even totally impossible. You cannot use a file system from Business Central cloud standard. So Azure can help you there. Let's go to the Azure portal. The Azure portal is a place where you select whatever you're doing, what you want to do in Azure. And in Azure, you can create resources. And one of the types of resource that you could create is called a storage account. And a storage account is what it tells in the name. It's an account where you can use storage, hard disk space, essentially, somewhere in the cloud. And there's several types. And what we're talking today is blob storage. Blob storage is essentially a place where you can just move your files. And I'll open it. Wow, this is not what I meant. Where is my blobs? Sorry. Where's my files today? Let's do this one. This is why you shouldn't do live demos. Where can I see what's in here? In a blob storage, you have containers. A container is essentially a folder of, as you're used to in your Windows file system. And in a container, you can have several files. And that's not just four like here, but it can be thousands upon thousands. Anything you can do on a file system, you can do here also. You can just store your files there. But you can also share these with other people. So you can use it, for example, if you print packing slips for things that you send to your customer, then you can send your customer a link and the customer can click on it and access the file from your blob storage, access the file from your solution. So essentially, you are having a file system in the cloud. You don't need to know where it is physically. You just know it is there in the cloud and you know how to access it. And you can give other people access to that. And it's also redundant, so very secure for things like hard disk failure, etc. So blob storage is one of the things that you can use on Azure. A second thing that you could use is regarding imports and export functions. Azure can interface with all kinds of software because you can write software in Azure. You can create something called an Azure function. And Azure functions are just pieces of software written in C# or any other language that you like, essentially. And you can use these functions to connect to external data sources, to retrieve data or to present an interface in Azure that people can send data to, and that Azure function then can send the data to your application, or your application can retrieve data from such a function. So you can use Azure functions for external communications. The profit there is that even if the external data source is changing, you can change that in your Azure function in one space, in one location. So you can just update your code once and it will work for every customer that is using your code from your solution. So if you have a solution that's deployed on 50 customer sites, they can all use the same Azure function with parameters, of course, and with security to get data into their system or out of their system. And you can manage that in Azure in a single location. So if you have an update, you just do it in Azure and all your customers have the new version right away. You don't have to update your customers to do that. So you can decouple your interfaces from your application in Business Central. The same goes with .NET. .NET functions, .NET software, .NET tools are used in Business Central to do calculations or to get data that's hard to get from Business Central itself. It can be a lot faster than code in Business Central. But .NET is not available in the cloud version of Business Central. So if you have something that uses .NET and you eventually want to go to the cloud version of Business Central, then the .NET version, .NET code will hold you back. So what you can do is the same as with the interfaces. You can create a .NET function. You can send the data from your Business Central environment to your .NET function, do calculations on there or do something with the data that you send there, and you can retrieve the result. I can show you a bit how you can do that in code. What you see here is one of the functions that we use for some of our customers. And this code is creating a CE case. That's a case, which is a document type in Dynamics 365 Customer Engagement. And you can create something there that your salespeople can follow up on, or your service people. What we do is we create something called a JSON variable. JSON is a language to describe data. And we add a title and we add customer account number and again a case ID, and we have several links that we add to the case. This is essentially the data that we are sending to customer engagement. This data is put into a content variable, and this content is sent using a REST interface, which is an interface using the Internet HTTP protocol to send data to another system. And this code is essentially the same for any function that I use to access an Azure function. And I send my data to the in this case to customer engagement, and I get a response back. So that's something that you have to remember. If you are using Azure functions, you have to send all the data that your function uses in your request, and you will get an answer back, and your Azure function cannot access your database. So you will have to send to collect all data before, and you will have to split out your data again when you get the response back. That means it's a lot, no, not a lot. It's a bit more work in AL to get your data in the right place. But it's also easy because you know that everything that will be sent there is in this one function. What also is a merit of this system is that you can use your Azure function from any software that you like. Maybe you have a calculation for salary payments. And this calculation is the same for every customer that you have. There are settings there, but in effect, the calculation is standard for each customer. So you can just send everything that you need calculated to the function. You can have Azure functions do the calculation and retrieve the result back. You have one function again. All your customers can use the calculation. And if something changes, you just have to modify your Azure function to get a better result. And you cannot only access that from Business Central, but you could access the same function, the same Azure function, from finance operations or from customer engagement, whatever you like. So moving calculations to Azure functions not only makes it better from a maintenance perspective, but it also gives you more possibilities to use it from other applications. So this goes for interfaces and for .NET. Then Azure can help you in case you are using SQL scripts. Well, not really. SQL scripts are scripts that access your database directly. And in cloud solutions, especially in Business Central Cloud, the database is not accessible to you, not accessible to your customers. It's only accessible through the Business Central software. So Business Central will encapsulate your database. But why are you using SQL scripts? In a lot of cases, that is because it's much quicker than processing data in Business Central. So essentially, that's the same Azure functions that we were talking about before. You send a lot of data into an Azure function. Maybe the Azure function has their own database that you can access. The Azure function can do calculation and send the results back to Business Central. And there you can add it to the Business Central database, but only just read and write, no calculation there. So only the, let's say, the easy part you need to do in Business Central. What I forgot to tell you in the part about the file system is if you're going to move to Business Central Cloud anytime, you probably know that the database size for Business Central Cloud is limited. You don't have a database that can grow and grow and grow and grow, but it will grow until I think currently the limit is 80 gigabytes. And after that, you will have to buy extra database size, something like that. details I don't know. My colleagues will be able to tell you about that. But so what you want to do is you want to use everything that you don't actually need in your SQL database. You want that in some other form of storage, like blob storage. And blob storage is relatively cheap storage. So SQL scripts for getting data into your database may be a good solution, but maybe it's a better solution to get the data that you need processed into blob storage or some other method, and then have only the results in your Business Central database. Of course, Azure can do more, and it can do things that you cannot do currently. One of the advantages of using Azure Functions and Azure Storage is security. If you have a customer environment and your environment is on premise, there you have probably Windows servers, at least one, but probably two or three or four. And these servers will be open to the internet. There will be a firewall available, and there will be a lot of security features there. But I don't know about you, but I'm not a security expert. And we don't have time to do security monitoring 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. But Microsoft is big enough to do that. So if you use Azure Functions, for the first thing is they run on servers that are monitored by Microsoft. They're maintained by Microsoft. So security is built in there. And the same goes for anything that's serverless on Azure. So blob storage, Azure Functions, anything that you use there will be monitored automatically. If you go to the virtual machine on Azure, then in that case, things like security updates are still something that you need to take care of. There's more. Everything you do on Azure gives you metrics. I'll open my portal again. And if I go to one of the Azure functions that we have running, is this one, and out of the box, without any configuration, we've got metrics, the data going into our application, the data going out of our application, so we can monitor what is happening. And we can monitor things like response time. Well, this is not a heavily used application, but you can see what's happening on Azure. And you can have logging, and you can have exception reports based on this data. So if you have a function on Azure, it will automatically provide you with these kinds of metrics. If I go to my blob storage, then again, my storage has metrics. Anything I write to the storage shows up here somewhere. I can see how much data is written, how much data is read, how much space I've left, if I need to buy more space, or whatever I like. So metrics, telemetry, is something that's standard in everything you do on Azure. And you probably know that telemetry will also be available for Business Central cloud environments. So if you have a Business Central cloud environment, you can define something called a telemetry instance ID. It's called different, a key. And that key will make sure that the telemetry from your customer environments can be available to you as a partner. So you can see what's going on a meta level in your customer environments. If there's something going wrong because they've got very high CPU usage, or something wrong because interfaces don't run, and maybe so you don't see things from your interface logging coming up in your events. Let's keep this telemetry in mind and let's go to application development in Business Central in AL. If I go to the app.json file in Business Central, which is the file where you define things about your application, I can add there something called an application insights key. So also in applications that you are building for Business Central, you can already assign an insights key, which is the key that the data is written to. And that key, if it's available, will tell you things about your app and your app's performance in Business Central Cloud. Is this the only way to do it? No. You can also write this code yourself. I've got here a code unit called metrics management, which we wrote ourselves. And what we can do is we can create something called an event in Application Insights that's called a custom event. And I can add data to that event, like in this case, a job queue that's being started. I can add a description and I can add a starting date time. I can add the parameters that the job queue is running with. And I can, when the job queue is finished, add a metric that says, okay, this job queue took 20 seconds to run, something like that. And this event can be submitted. Let's go to that code. Oops, it's there, I know. Why not? Ah, froggy. Again, don't do this on live demos. It's in a table. Metric. Once I created the event that I want to show in my Application Insights, I can send it to, in this case, a service called services.visualstudio.com, which is an Azure function, which is an Azure hosted service. And I can send my data there and I will have an insight in how often will my job queues run and how long do they take. And we have job queues that are supposed to run every hour. So we can just monitor and check that every hour we get something in my event view that the job queue has run. Sometimes it doesn't run could be something situational. So maybe it will run automatically next time, next hour. But if it doesn't, then we can raise an event from that, and we can have a support engineer look into why a job queue is not running. And if your job queue is usually running for 20 seconds and now it's running for an hour, maybe you know that something is wrong in your job queue. So telemetry helps you a lot. I started today's session telling you that it's for any version of Business Central. What I show you here is AL code, but I can also show you exactly the same thing here in CSite, in CAL, and it runs exactly the same. It looks a bit different, but it's still the job queue, the description, and I can send, here it works. I can send my event to my application inside Azure function. So even if you're not using Business Central with AL in a cloud solution, you can still use application insights and metrics from Azure to measure the performance of your application. And you can write logging events there, so you can see that things did happen or did not happen in a certain amount of time. So telemetry is something that will definitely improve the service that you can deliver to your customers. Now you see that a lot of the things that are surrounding your solution, your product for your customer, all kinds of things that are not in the AL code or not in the CAL code can be managed through, can be performed by Azure. The thing is, if you start moving your code, even if your customer is not upgrading to AL, and even if your customer is not going to be on Business Central Cloud, you can still start modifying your application and use Azure functions and use Azure functionality. And if you've done that, then the move, if your customer wants to go to cloud, and if you want to update your solution to cloud, then you will be ready, and the code change will be much, much, much less than if you have not done this and you're still using all kinds of .NET code or file system access or SQL scripts. So one of the things that you can do now in existing installations that are even that are not going to cloud soon, you can still start to prepare, because anytime soon your customer will need to go to the cloud in some way, or you have to tell them that they can't, and that's something that maybe is not the best message that you will have to send them. Are there any questions? Feel free to unmute yourself.
Currently no questions in the chat function either, Jan, at the moment.
Okay, no problem. I hope that means that I'm clear. What I have to say is that for Azure Blob Storage, there is a training coming up in next month. There'll be a one-day training through QBS using how to use Azure Blob Storage for Business Central. And you will be able to register for this soon. I don't know how soon that will be, but it'll be really soon.
I can say when, right? I'm just waiting for it to be set up sometime next week because of the holidays. I would have liked it to be live in the academy, and that's simply not going to happen this week. Okay, so sometime next week, keep your eyes peeled on the website in the academy. This will become available and we can start taking registrations. Okay, and just to make it clear, it is going to be delivered by Gunnar Gertsen, who's very well known in the channel, is an MVP.
Yep.
And so very proud to bring that number over to you guys, right?
Okay. Then that brings me to the end of my webinar for today. If you still have questions, just reach out to me or to anybody from QBS and they will direct you to me probably. Thank you for attending and maybe see you next time.
Thank you, Jan. Thanks everybody for attending today. We'll share the recording shortly. Take care.